Moving on to more business news, an intercorporate dispute in one of the country's biggest casino hotel, Okada Manila, has resulted in a physical takeover of the premises Tuesday. In a video and statement provided to ABS-CBN News by the lawyers of Tiger Resort Leisure Entertainment Incorporated, which operates Okada Manila, 50 private guards and police officers of the Parañaque City Police and a sheriff of the Parañaque City Regional Trial Court accompanied a group led by former board member Tony Boy Cuanco in allegedly employing brute force and intimidation to compel key legitimate officers of Okada Manila to vacate the premises. The takeover stemmed from a case filed by Mr. Kazuo Okada to reverse his removal as shareholder, director, and chairman of TRLEI in June 2017 due to serious violation of governance over a $17.3 million loan. The case has now reached the Supreme Court, which issued a status quo ante order on April 27 this year, ordering parties to return to the situation before Okada was removed. But according to TRLEI's lawyers, the takeover has no basis because Okada only held one share of stock in the corporation and did not have the authority to take control of it. Joining us now to discuss this issue further is attorney TRLEI Lamparo, senior partner at Divina Law, the Council for Tiger Resort Leisure Entertainment Incorporated, or TRLEI. Good morning, attorney Lamparo. Thank you for speaking to us today.
Good morning, Mike, and good morning, Nikki.
Attorney Lamparo, first let me begin with what happened yesterday. We saw a bit of a commotion in the video. Who were these people who took over Okada Manila, and who are these people being led out of the premises?
Yes, what's shown in the video is actually the tail end of the stockholders meeting that we were holding inside one of the conference rooms or ballrooms in Okada. So after the forced entry of the group of Mr. Tony Boy Cuanco and the goons, we call them goons because they were very, very violent, and private guards that accompanied them, we convened a stockholders meeting, and while we were having stockholders meeting, they all of a sudden turned off the electricity. So as you can see, there were no lights inside the conference room. They all of a sudden turned off the electricity, and the guards, these guards swooped down on the ballroom and forcibly evicted us. They tried several times. When we did not relent, what they did was they physically took Mr. Hajime Tokuda, one of the directors of the company, and who can't even speak English. He only speaks Japanese. So they took him physically from his chair and forced him down the lobby and into an unknown vehicle, and was brought eventually to his house. We don't know where else they went. But as of last night, we confirmed that he was already home, and he was really, really traumatized. So this was kidnapping that happened right in front of our eyes. The rest of us who remained in the room were shoved, pushed, and forced out of the hotel until we left. We were followed by the guards, even in the parking area, just to ensure that we wouldn't be able to go back. It was really a very unprecedented and violent takeover.
So who is in control of Okada Manila now, and is it still in operation? Are the tenants also operating?
Well, from information, the ones who went there yesterday and tried to conduct a meeting were the group of Mr. Tony Boy Cuanco, Dindo Espeleta, their lawyer, Florencio Herrera. We don't know the identities of the other people present, but there were quite a number of them there. They were accompanied by private guards that they brought from their own security agency. Apparently, there was a sheriff of the RTC of Parañaque with them, and the Parañaque police officers were there, no less than we were informed that no less than the chief of police of Parañaque and his deputy were there, despite the fact that there was no court order directing police assistance. Because ordinarily, Mike, and I'm sure you're familiar with this kind of procedure, if a party seeks to secure the assistance of police officers in the execution of an order or a ruling, one needs to file a motion in court, in fact, because the police won't act without a ruling or an order from the court. In this case, they did not even bother to do that. So we were shocked when the Paranaque mm-hmm. police were there. And in fact, when I was being forcibly taken out of the conference area where their group were meeting, around four or five private guards had to physically carry me because I refused to leave until I am shown a copy of the order that they were implementing. We were never, by the way, furnished or shown a copy of the order that they were implementing. When this was all happening, when all this violence was happening, the Paranaque police officers were there and I was asking for their help because I was getting mm-hmm. hurt. But at one point, my shoes came off. I dropped my bag because I was being very violently restrained and they were doing nothing. So apparently they were there to assist the other side.
Mm-hmm. Attorney Lamparo, let's explain to our viewers what's the basis for the takeover. Let's backtrack a bit to give our viewers a clearer picture of the situation. I understand that this case goes all the way back to June 2017 when Mr. Okada was removed as shareholder, director, and chairman of TRLEI. But why was he removed?
Okay, he was removed because of the mismanagement that he committed in the past. But in 2017, he only had one share. That's clear from the records, Mike. So TRLEI, the company that owns Okada Manila, has at least 5 billion shares, 8 million, more than 8 million common shares, and around 4.8 billion preferred shares. And Mr. Okada only had one share at that time. But in June 2017, the deed of trust in favor of Mr. Okada over that one share was revoked. So his one share was removed from him. Mm-hmm. After June 2017, he owned zero share in TRLEI. So he didn't bother to file an election contest, which was a requirement under the rules after he was removed as a shareholder and as a director and chairman of the board. He did not bother to file an election contest within 15 days. He mm-hmm. filed a case about a year after his removal, not an election contest, to question the revocation of the deed of trust and to question the removal, his removal as a shareholder. The RTC ruled against him and mm-hmm. confirmed the validity of his removal as a shareholder. He filed an appeal with the Court of Appeals. The Court of Appeals affirmed the RTC ruling and again declared valid his removal as shareholder. He filed a motion for reconsideration with the Court of Appeals. The Court of Appeals affirmed its ruling. Unperturbed, he filed then a petition with the Supreme Court, initially a petition with the Supreme Court asking for a TRO and a writ of preliminary injunction. That TRO, that prayer for TRO, was never granted. However, recently, in a very, very curious and surprising move, he filed a supplemental petition. A supplemental petition which this time prayed not for a TRO, but for the issuance of a status quo ante order. And under the intercorporate rules, you can pray for the issuance of a status quo ante order only if you post a bond. He didn't even bother to post a bond. Nonetheless, to make the long story short, he prayed in that application for status quo ante order that he be reinstated as shareholder in TRLEI, and at the same time that he be reinstated as a nominee of the mother company of TRLEI, which is Tiger Resorts Asia, the Hong Kong company. However, he did not bother to implead in the case TRA. So TRA never made a party to the case. It was only TRLEI, the local company. So when the Supreme Court issued the status quo ante order, it could not have issued any directive or order to TRA, which was never made a party to the case. It could only issue an order to the respondent, which was TRLEI. And the directive of the Supreme Court, the very, very clear directive of the Supreme Court, was for the parties to restore the status prior to the removal of Mr. Okada, a shareholder. And like I said, like we explained earlier, prior to his removal as shareholder, he only had one share. That's mm-hmm. not 7.1% of the shareholdings of TRLEI. That's because TRA owns 99.9% of the shares of TRLEI. So he only had one share. He has no business. With that one share, he definitely has no business taking control of the resort, of the hotel, taking control of the company. And yet, yesterday, that's what he did. His representatives by force and intimidation.
Attorney Lamparo, to our viewers who may not be familiar with the workings in the corporate world, how is it possible that a shareholder with only one share of stock can be elected as director and even chairperson of a company? Explain mm-hmm. that to us.
Yes, it was possible prior to 2017 because at that time, on top of his one share, he was nominated as the representative of TRA, the mother company. Mm-hmm. That nomination by TRA had been withdrawn by TRA. TRA is now represented by Mrs. Takako Okada and Mr. Kenshi Asano. So he mm-hmm. is no longer the representative of TRA. That representation of TRA, the mother company, allowed him to be chairman and board member of the company. But since there is already a ruling in the court of Japan, a final ruling, in fact, which affirmed the validity of his removal from TRA. Then he could no longer claim to be representative of TRA. But he concealed this fact. See, he concealed these facts from the Supreme Court. And that's why we have taken issue with this in our motion for reconsideration. He concealed the fact that he is no longer part of TRA. He was showing an old GIS, a 2016 GIS, did not bother to present to the court the 2021 GIS of the company, showing he no longer had any interest in OHD, in UEC, TRA, and TRA. These are the mother companies. So OHD mm-hmm. owns 2/3 of UEC. UEC owns TRA, and TRA owns TRLEI. So his ouster from these companies had been affirmed not just by the Japan court, but likewise by the Hong Kong court. All these were concealed from the Supreme Court. So it appears that even our high court was misled by Mr. Okada.
Mm-hmm. Attorney Lamparo, at this point, does Mr. Kazuo Okada have any interest at all in TRLEI? You did say that he no longer owns any shares, no longer nominee, but I know that the mother company that you mentioned, OHL, he still holds 46.55%. That's Okada Holdings Limited, which indirectly owns TRLEI.
That's not true. That was already litigated in the Japan court, Mike. Mm-hmm. It was affirmed that it is now the son of Mr. Okada, Kazuo Okada, who owns OHL, who controls mm-hmm. OHL. So he no longer controls OHL, even the mother company.
But does he still have any interest in the mother company?
As far as no more. No more. He was mm-hmm. ousted.
Hmm. And the question here, Attorney Lamparo, what's the business of Mr. Tony Boy Cuanco in accompanying the takeover of Okada Manila, if he is not a board of director? Was he a board of director before June 2017?
He was at one point, after 2017, in fact, he was at one point a board member. He was a nominee of one share, but that one share was likewise removed from him. As of this time, he doesn't own a single share in TRLEI. So that makes this takeover all the more anomalous. He is not a party in the Supreme Court case. It's only Mr. Kazuo Okada. Him and Mr. Dindo Espeleta are not parties in the Supreme Court case. So we're really mm-hmm. wondering what their participation is in this violent takeover.
And just to be clear, the effect of the status quo ante order is to return to the situation prior to Mr. Okada's removal in June 2017, Attorney mm-hmm. Lamparo.
And that means the restoration of Mr. Okada to his one share, which our client is honoring. We have honored the return of his one share. But as an owner of one share, you cannot take control of an entire company that consists, that has more than 5 billion shares. So one mm-hmm. share is nothing.
Does the status quo ante order also restore him as chair of TRLEI? And by being chair, does that entitle him to control of the premises?
That's the problem, Mike. He cannot be restored to his chairmanship because that would involve the participation of a party that was not made or that was not implicated in the case. It would have, TRA would have to be directed to reinstate him as nominee because it's his being the nominee of the TRA that enabled him to be chairman. That is out of TRLEI's control. However, TRA was never implicated. In fact, TRA has already been able to obtain a final ruling from the Japan court that Mr. Okada has no participation in TRA. So unless TRA is implicated and TRA is directed to, again, nominate Mr. Okada as its representative, how can a shareholder that holds only one share become chairman? And I would like to point out also, Mike, in addition, while the Supreme Court directed the restoration of the status quo prior to 2017, it nowhere said in the order that Petitioner Okada can force his way into the Okada Hotel. It nowhere allowed him to take by force the physical premises. It restores his one share. But there's nothing there that says that he can take physical control of the entire premises and take over all the employees of the hotel. So this is what's anomalous. The SQAO is not an eviction order. Mm-hmm. It is a status quo ante order. And we were shocked yesterday that it appears that the RTC, that the sheriff of the RTC of Paranaque was there along the team that implemented supposedly the status quo ante order. The RTC Paranaque, in fact, decided against Mr. Okada. There is no pending case with the RTC of Paranaque, and there is no writ. Ordinarily, the sheriff of a trial court participates in the execution of a writ issued after an appeal is resolved or after a ruling is made by a higher court and a writ is issued by the trial court, then the sheriff executes that writ. There is no such writ here. What they apparently are implementing is merely the status quo ante order that says nothing about a physical takeover of the premises. Ordinarily, a ruling like that by the Supreme Court, it is only served by the Supreme Court's process server on the parties. And if the parties disobey, if the respondents disobey that status quo ante order, if their position is we are disobeying that status quo ante order, they can file a motion to declare us in contempt of court. Mm-hmm. They cannot just direct the sheriff of the lower court, get 50 goons along with them and even the police of the almost the entire police force of Paranaque to accompany them and to assist them in forcibly taking over the hotel. So this is really unprecedented on so many counts. It's very anomalous how it happened. I said we are still in the process of assessing the steps that we are going to take, but definitely we will be filing cases left and right. We cannot normalize this kind of impunity. We cannot condone this kind of abuse of court processes. This is really just unprecedented.
And will you go after the police officers, the sheriff, and all the other individuals who were present in that takeover?
We will look at the facts very carefully. We will gather all the facts and definitely we will hold accountable everyone who participated in that illegal takeover.
In the meantime, what will the staff or the personnel or the officers of TRLEI do to ensure a smooth continuing operations for your clients?
Well, right now, our clients are not in physical control of the premises. So we are actually unaware what the plan of the interlopers are as far as the employees, the existing employees, and as far as the existing operations of the hotel are concerned. As you know, Okada is one of the premier, if not the premier, leisure and entertainment center in Manila. And you know, the lives of these employees, their families are also at stake here, and of course the patrons of Okada. So of course we wouldn't want even us as real owners, even our client as real owners of the hotel, wouldn't want any disruption in the operation. So we will of course not sabotage in any way or disrupt in any way the operations of the hotel. That's not what an owner does. What we will try to do is hold accountable those people who were responsible for the illegal takeover. And right now, our most urgent task is to call the attention of the Supreme Court to the forcible takeover, to the illegalities and anomalies that happened yesterday. And we will seek the proper remedies from the court.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, as Attorney Estrella Ilamparo, the counsel for TRLEI. In the interest of fairness, we also invited and we reached out to the lawyers of Mr. Kazuo Okada, but they told us that they are still discussing whether to grant us an interview.